The Jazz and Arts Festival will run from May 5th to the 14th with a lineup of national, regional, and international artists. The festival will also be punctuated with cultural and artistic expressions under the general theme Arts and the City. While he is all for a good time, former Gros Islet MP Leonard Montoute questions reintroducing the event given the current economic environment.
We are at the juncture now where we have to seriously consider our expenditure as a nation. Can we afford to Can we afford to expend resources in areas that will not bring the kind of returns that will justify the expenditure? That is my concern at this point in time. I do not know that the output in terms of the resources that will be expended on that event will justify the returns. And remember, the Jazz Festival primarily was organized for the purpose of bringing tourists to St. Lucia. That's the primary purpose. Of course, we have a good time at the same. I mean, you know, we locals enjoy and have a good time, but that's not the primary purpose for it. So we have to ask ourselves, is it serving that purpose? And if not, can we afford?
Speaking at the press launch of the event on Tuesday, Tourism Minister Dr. Ernest Hillen noted that over the years, the returns had far exceeded the investments made in the festival. He believes the same will hold true with this year's festival.
When you measure the Jazz Festival and criticize probably the amount that is spent, you're really missing the point. We will never make back those monies in gate receipts. But look at the home accommodation sector, the hotels, the restaurants, and see the kind of returns we get from the Jazz Festival. It's not just about a marketing tool anymore. It's part of our economic development, and it's part of creating economic activity in this country.
The tourism minister also underscored that the Jazz and Arts Festival had become a staple of the island's events calendar. For the DBS Newsworld, I am Zane Romulus.